In our next hour, former Secretary of State Colin Powell will join us live. And in the meantime, as members of Congress weigh the political impact of Wednesday's siege on the Capitol, many are also grappling with the personal trauma they experienced. These were men and women simply going about their work in what was supposed to be one of the most secure places in the world. Then, in an instant, chaos. I spoke with Congressman Jason Crow of Colorado. He's a former Army Ranger who was trapped inside the House gallery when rioters breached the final police barrier outside.
The security came in, the Capitol Police came in, and they whisked away the speaker and the leadership and then started to evacuate.
You were stuck in the gallery with other members.
We were stuck in the gallery. There were about 15 or 20 of us there, and within a few minutes, we heard yelling and screaming, grenades going off. And next thing I know, the police actually were shutting and locking the doors, locking us in to the chamber and starting to grab furniture and stack it against the windows and the doors. And that's when I knew that we were in trouble. I called my wife and told her that I loved her and to tell the kids that I loved them. We were putting our gas masks on, and I was helping the other members figure out how to do that because that's something I had done hundreds of times in the Army. You know, I had a pen in my pocket and was thinking about how we were going to fight our way out.
There's an image that has really gone around the world today of you comforting one of your colleagues. What happened in that moment?
The police had their guns drawn and had barricaded the walls, and we thought that they were going to be able to make it in. And Susan is a friend of mine. You know, I did what any friend would do, and Susan did the same. We were comforting each other. I was thinking about how we were going to get ourselves out of it.
You're a veteran. You're a combat veteran. Did you ever think you would feel like that inside the United States Capitol?
What I felt in the Capitol behind us is something that I haven't felt since I was in Afghanistan as an Army Ranger. And to think that as a member of Congress in 2021 in the U.S. Capitol on the House floor, that I was preparing to fight my way out of the people's house against a mob is just beyond troubling.
Are you angry that this was able to happen?
I am angry. I'm tired. I'm very angry at Donald Trump, who bears primary responsibility for this. I'm angry at his enablers, because Donald Trump isn't really the story anymore. We know him. There's no surprise that he would do this. What this is about now are the people around him, his advisors, the members of Congress, and others that have allowed this to happen. This was a catastrophic security failure. If this had been a military operation, all the commanders would have been instantly relieved of duty.
Do you support other Democrats, some Republicans who were talking about the 25th Amendment, talking about removal from office, talking about impeachment, if for no other reason to send a message?
Absolutely. For a long time have said that we know who Donald Trump is. He is a dangerous man. About a year ago, I was an impeachment manager making the case for his removal. I knew the danger that he presented, and I knew that this could happen. And here we are, a year later, and it's happened. The cabinet officials, the vice president, they bear responsibility here. They have allowed this to happen, and they can assume that responsibility and make it right by invoking the 25th Amendment.
How are you feeling as you try to just deal with the emotions of what have happened in this sacred place?
I want to get back to my family. I want to hug my kids, be with them for a little while. But I'm also feeling tremendous resolve. The insurrectionists tried to derail our democracy yesterday. They failed because our government, our democracy is bigger than any one of them. We have some dark times ahead and a lot of work ahead of us. After I go home and spend some time with my kids, I'm going to roll my sleeves up and we're going to do that work.
Hoda, we have a lot of recent veterans who are now serving. They've decided they're going to now serve their country by serving in Congress. And it's simultaneously inspiring and heartbreaking that so many of them had to return to that mindset, that battle mode. What could I use? How could I fight my way out? How could I protect my fellow members and the staffers here in that horrible day?
I mean, you interviewed him for a couple of minutes yesterday. I'm so glad you went in depth to hear him say he only felt that way when he was in Afghanistan. It was so jarring, but his resolve, boy, just made me have my back a little straighter. That was an extraordinary interview.
These veterans are the best of us.
No
kidding. There's no question.
Yeah.